Hello guys, good day. This is Anne of Reinforcement Club. Today we are going to talk about empowering youth. Since nowadays, social media is getting wild, as well as the environment. And the young generations has been a lot more unpredictable this time. Inflation rates, prices are hiking up. We can hardly afford to live. And that also contributes to the family connection, bonding together. But the truth of the matter is, we still have to take care of each other, especially the young ones, the teens, our children, our little ones. We try to nurture them so that they can able to improve their self-worth, protect themselves as they venture the world when they grow older, like us, becoming into a responsible adults. Now, I am going to bring about the topic of self-esteem today, because nowadays bullying, social media pressures, peer pressure is. Our young ones, the teenagers are quite prone to this, this time sending pictures to one another, or, our kids could get into a fight, or our kids could be prone to bad influences. Now, I do believe that one of the best way to protect themselves against the danger of social media as well as the bad influences in their environment is to really increase, to enhance their self-esteem. Now, self-esteem is our own self-worth, how we value ourselves, how we perceive our own abilities, our qualities, our own value, our life. Having high self-esteem means we are confident with our own abilities, and we trust our decisions with all due respect to our own self-belief, our own self-image. Having a high self-esteem, having confidence to do things on our own, we can take more challenges and pursue goals without being overwhelmed by the adversities, by the setbacks along the way. Although there could be tendencies that, problems along the way could wear us off, could put us down, but having a high self-esteem, having a high value of self-worth, we put in ourselves, we can be resilient. Resilient in a way that we can able to bounce back from our failures, from painful, hurtful criticisms, because we don't want to let ourselves down. We fight for ourselves. We love ourselves. We value ourselves. We believe in ourselves that we can get through this and still hit the target in the long run. And those external factors, we can conquer them. Although in some point we're going to get hurt. But, having a kind of high value self-worth we put in ourselves, we can do anything. We can get our act together, pick ourselves up, and then bounce back. And it's not easy. It's not easy to fail, to feel like you're a failure in some point. But once you learn the lesson of that, that's the best part. You're gonna get your act together, attack stronger, being a better you once you pick yourself up and build yourself back together and still aim for that prize in the long run. And when we have high self-esteem, especially when we, as a teenager, when we try to help them enhance their self-esteem, these young ones with high self-esteem have healthier relationships. they're likely to build, to can able to build and protect their boundaries and surround themselves with supportive people compared to those teenagers and even young adults having low self-esteem. They constantly doubt their abilities, their worth, leading to hesitancy of pursuing their goals because they don't believe in themselves. They don't have confidence to make decisions on their own or even fight for their own decisions. And having a low self-esteem means they have a negative perception on themselves. Having a low self-esteem means we focus on our flaws. And we focus on the problems ahead. We overthink. And we easily get overwhelmed with the shortcomings. We tend to forget about our strengths. And even young adults and teenagers are prone to peer pressure, most especially if they have low self-esteem. They don't know their real value. They'll be prone to, you know, to bad influences, to seek validation from others. That's quite risky, especially if they're seeking validation from the wrong people. You know, let me relate this to my past. I have learned to drink and smoke through my friends, although we're good friends, but it's where I learn from them. My parents doesn't drink. They both smoke. I started smoking, trying to emulate them while I was around 5 years old. Just, you know, a piece of paper, forming it into a small cigarette. That's how tricky I was. And even my mom found it out. I don't know if she can ever able to remember. But I was officially a social smoker in my teenager years, around 19, 20 years old. Because some of my close friends, they smoke. And of course, majority of them, they drink. And my parents doesn't drink ever. I haven't seen them drinking. I just learned it from my friends. The good thing about it is that, you know, I have good friends, and so far we didn't get ourselves into trouble. We're not against the law. We're not into drugs. Drinking and smoking is just for the sake of having fun. And thank God I didn't go to jail for that. Although there are some crucial moments, you know, we had with my friends. But so far, we didn't get into that point. So what I'm trying to say right now is that when you seek validation from others, not from ourselves, from yourself, we are prone to be influenced by those bullies, by bad people, by those people who are selling drugs, by those people who are taking advantage, even to pedophiles. If the young ones or young adults have low self-esteem, no or almost no boundaries, they can easily be taken advantage of those people who are dominantly bad. Now, how are we going to develop, enhance, or promote high self-esteem to our children, to the young ones, even to not only to our children, to our brothers, young brothers and sister, for our young friends? Now, that could be young cousins though. So the first thing that we could ever do basically is to provide a supportive environment. Create a supportive and nurturing environment where the young ones or the teens or our kids feel valued and accepted for who they are. We don't ask anything outside themselves. If that's the only grade that they can have, take it as it is. If they can't make it to the A, you know, get an A grade, take it as it is. If they are not the top of the class, still give them the best love in the world. They could not be the top in the class kind of kids, but they are the best of the friends, the best child that you ever have, who values himself, who loves himself, who loves his brothers and sisters, who is a good friend, who have all the right characters as a person. You don't have to look for something else outside or attributes that the kid doesn't have. Validate their feelings and opinions and offer constructive feedbacks. If they can't make it to be on top of the class, to be the best sports, the best athlete, still validate them. Still trust them. Still make them feel secure. Still love them as they are. Other than that, you could give them constructive feedbacks that could help them ponder about improving themselves. Give them option to really take actions for their own personal development. Another thing that we can do to promote self-esteem for the young ones is through encouraging them how to take care of themselves. Self-care. Encourage the young ones to prioritize activities such as healthy diet, exercise, adequate sleep, relaxation techniques. You know, there's a lot of varieties to choose from in this generation. You could encourage them to enroll in sports, karate, taekwondo, yoga, enroll themselves to the gym if they want to, if they are in the right age. Because having a healthy body, having a physical well-being, you know, our physical well-being will impact, for sure, our mental well-being. Have you got this situation we're in? You really want to do something. You want to travel into this mysterious place. It could be in another country. But you can't make it because of your health. The mind is stronger than the body. So if you want to really be capable of anything else that you can imagine, strengthen your body and mind. Match your mental health with your physical health. And that to that point, you can do anything. Health is wealth. Sometimes the body is weak, but the mind is too strong. There's a lot of possibilities that you can do, but you're not capable of because of your health. That's how important your health is. So again, health is wealth. Another thing that we can do to help the young ones develop self-esteem is to encourage them set a realistic goals. Help our young ones to set achievable goals and celebrate their progress along the way. This way, help them foster the sense of competence and accomplishment. Okay, let's just say they want to be in top of the class. That's what they want to have. So encourage them to study. And even though they are not the first, you know, the champ, the first honor of the class, they only got the third honor, second honor, you know, still be happy for them. Be there, be present. And make them feel that you're proud. Make them feel love, because that love, that proudness that you give to them, that's the best thing that ever happens. That's the best feeling in the world. They may not remember the moment, you know, about the awarding, the commencement exercise, but your presence in those situations, in that happenings with them, you know, the feeling, it's the feeling that they won't ever forget all their life. I don't remember much about dad because I grew up with dad, but we have loads of time together because I only decided to separate myself from dad when I became young adult. So we got loads of moments together, and I could hardly remember them all, but for sure, there's only one thing that's for sure. I know that dad loves me 100% and he will do anything for me. He treated me like a fragile baby chicken, baby chick. That's how my dad treats me. He doesn't even want me to fail. He cannot manage himself seeing me cry. That's why I just don't let him see me cry. I don't remember a lot of happenings that we were together. But for sure, I know that my dad loves me 200%. It's the feeling. I still have this love, you know, I still have the father's love in my heart. And for sure, even when I reach 80 or 60 years old, I still have that feeling of love from my dad, which is, I'm pretty much sure I can trust and I will carry for the rest of my life. I can even give this to my children, share this love to my children, my dad's love. Now, yeah, my dad before, he doesn't ask much. He took me as I am. The terrible daughter, the good daughter, it depends on the season. So my dad doesn't demand much from me. I do demand much from myself. I make my own goals. I make decisions. But I am also prone to those bad influences because in some point I also had low self-esteem when I was younger. So parents, brothers, and sisters, let's help together protect the young ones. And of course, we could also encourage our young children or brothers and sisters, young friends, to have a positive self-talk. Like, we are our own best friend. Teach the teens to recognize and challenge the negative self-talk by replacing it with positive affirmations. You know what? You could even argue to yourself. When your head is telling you can't do this, you know, this makes you uncomfortable. You can even argue, make an argument out of that. I'm already a young adult now. But, okay, FYI. We can argue with ourselves. We can pose a challenge. We can challenge ourselves. We can challenge our comfort zone. We can go against ourselves and face the consequence. Our brain is actually made to protect us. And the only way to increase our capability, our comfort zone, is to try to go beyond those protection. And that's the time wherein we feel uncomfortable. Now, as we grow up, as we go along, we know already our strengths and weaknesses. And whenever we decide, we know the risks. So take note of the risks in the most part, the consequences. Because whatever the new things that we do, whenever we challenge our brain, whenever we make arguments with our inside our head that we can really do this, whatever happens, we do this. And that's it. It's done. But before anything else, make sure to calculate the risks, the consequences, before taking action. So let's encourage positive self-talk. And, you know, to be able to protect, to encourage the young ones, to protect themselves from people who would surely take advantage to them, you might want to consider teaching the young ones, or I could say this to myself, we could consider teaching the young ones to be assertive. Teach the young ones to communicate their needs, to set boundaries, and to stand up for themselves. It all starts from them. Even us, when we were young, we do this, especially now that we're adults. And it's time to hand the lessons that we've learned to the young ones. Set boundaries to protect ourselves. Stand up for ourselves if we need to. And communicate our needs in a healthy manner, in a respectable manner. And, you know, we could also help the teens identify the red flags. everybody has criteria, but those people who have low self-esteem, they also have criteria. It's just that they are willing to make it negotiable. They are willing to lower their criteria to fit in. So that's just the problem. Now, we have to teach the young ones identify the red flags, even ourselves, the young adults. Educate the teens about the signs of manipulative behaviors, manipulative adults, such as excessive flattery, controlling tendencies, and those people who disregard boundaries that we set. So help them understand that they can always walk away from those people who never respect them as they are, who makes them feel uncomfortable. Walk away. That's the boundary. Encourage them to build a trusted relationships. Encourage the teens to build relationships with individuals who respect and support them. This is one of the best ways to really design the environment. So this won't take up a lot of time and efforts. Just be intentional with our environment. Teach them to build their own healthy environment. Emphasize the importance of surrounding themselves with people who uplift them rather than bring them down. And in the most part, promote critical thinking. Teach the young ones to evaluate situations and learn from those situations. Help the young ones evaluate people themselves, make decisions, trust their decisions, how they perceive this person, having relationship with this person. And of course, trust their instincts, trust their hunch. If they feel that there's something isn't right. Encourage our young ones to have open communication. So they can feel comfortable to really seek guidance and support from people like us, from their significant others whom they can trust, from their parents, from their trusted brothers and sisters. Now, let's take this two scenario. Let's compare the teenagers having high self-esteem versus low self-esteem teenagers. Those teens with high self-esteem, they can set boundaries with their peers confidently. They can decline risky invitations by means of evaluating the behaviors of the people they hang out with. These teens or young people with high self-esteem surrounds themselves with people who are healthy for them, people who uplift them, people who knows how to validate them in a positive manner, people who wants the best for them, who challenges them in a good way. Now, having, those teens or young ones with high self-esteem, they can approach people in an assertive manner, wherein they can easily set boundaries and ready to walk away. They can be resilient during problematic seasons of their life. They have the determination to overcome obstacles. They know how to take care of their body, of their mental health. They know when to seek advice and guidance from their parents, from the trusted people. They, those young ones who have high self-esteem, they trust themselves. They trust their hunch. They assertively make decisions for their own betterment. They protect themselves. They know their criteria. They set their boundaries. And like those young ones who have low self-esteem can easily be manipulated by the bullies because they let their guard down. They set their boundaries down in order to fit in order to please others. They don't trust themselves. Now they sacrifice themselves for others. And they end up, of course, accepted, but controlled and unhappy. So, you know, I'm trying to bring this out because this is important. The world is going crazy, especially the social media. And, you know, these teenagers are prone to being exploited nowadays, internet-wise. And let's help each other. By the way, if you like this message today, you can share this to your family and friends. You can follow me in Facebook, YouTube, Spotify, and Apple Podcast, Reinforce Me Club. This is Anne, by the way, and I do appreciate your time. Have a lovely day ahead. Thank you very much.